I'm here to present how we are utilizing the satellite data for our nuclear power program. As you know, the Department of Atomic Energy is responsible for producing the clean energy for the country, and this is one of the national program. Apart from the solar power, the nuclear energy is also one of the major agenda of our government. And we had been the regular user of the satellite data as far as the exploration program required for the atomic minerals is concerned. I'll be putting here some of the things as Chairman mentioned that it should be able to give you a brief account of the how exploration is done for the atomic minerals and what are the other areas where the satellite data can be used. So in general, for the mineral exploration, as we know that it is an indirect guide in the mineral exploration. It provides a synoptic view, and we can use it in the different stages of the mineral exploration, whether it is the reconnaissance or the semi-detail or the detailed scale. It is first and foremost thing for the exploration program is to understand the geology of the area, the geological setting. For any other mineral exploration, the similar things here. So we use the satellite data for preparing the geological map and ultimately to the mineral potential map of that area. As far as the mineral exploration is concerned, apart from the geology, what is more important is that the alteration zones. And if we have to know about the alteration zones, where is the clay horizons which are present in the area, which can be the important target for the any mineral presence. And similarly, for the uranium exploration also, these important, these alteration zones are very, very important. Particularly, what happens then in the case of the uranium, uranium is normally available in the, in the earth crust in the form of the reduced, that is the U4 valency. And it gets oxidized to the uranium oxide, and that is the 6 valency. Once it gets that, it has to get reduced. In those conditions, this oxidation and the redox potential, they play a very, very important role. And that's why these alteration zones, which can be easily monitored with the help of the certain data products, are very consistently used. Now we are looking forward to use the hyperspectral remote sensing, which is very important for the mineral exploration program. Similarly, apart from hyperspectral, the microwave, particularly the area which are very, very remote and are normally covered in the northeastern part, which are very important for the uranium exploration program point of view, we are very actively using the microwave data as well. As far as the uranium exploration is concerned, if we know that it has got a, geologically, it has got a distinct period where the uranium mineralization has taken place. So those geological time periods are very important when those tectonic processes have taken place and precipitated the uranium. As we know, the, as I said, a quick geological favorability assessment for type of uranium mineralization is the major theme which we, with the, that we use the satellite data. So broadly, the four controls, stratigraphic, lithological, structural, as well as the geochemical. These are the different type of the uranium deposits which are present in the nature, and all of them have the different features which can be picked up by the satellite data products. I have just summarized it here. The first one is here, the unconformity related, which is one of the major thing here, and we can pick up here the regional geology, the alteration or the cover sediment, and the basement domain mapping we are doing with the help of the satellite data. Similarly, for the sandstone type of mineralization of, or the hematite breccia complex of the type of deposits, the regional structures which are playing the role, they are being picked up with the help of the satellite data. And the other type of mineralization like the vein type and the volcanic and the caldera type of related, again, the geological structure and the fault systems are being picked up with the help of the satellite data. The few other type of deposits, which are although very small, but they play important role in our resources, the surfacial type and the phosphorite type of deposit, because they come as the byproducts from the other things which are being mined. So lithological guides. We, as I said, that we can get with the help of the satellite data, the lithological guides. Then the structural guides, where the satellite data plays an important role. Then the alterations, basically the clay horizons. and the iron alterations. These are the some of the products which has been done. As I said, the geological mapping here, the one of the geological map which has been prepared, because we require the large scale geological maps which are very important for the exploration point of view. So the available maps which are there from the Geological Survey of India, most of the time they do not suffice for that purpose. And now the high resolution satellite data is playing a very important role in that. This is the product which has been done after the mapping. Then some of the case histories. This is a part of the Meghalaya where we have a very important deposit, the Wakin and the Domeshad deposit, where we have used the IRS PAN data. We observed that there is a difference in the Mahadevic sandstones. There are two types of the texture what we are observing. The one is the channel facies and the another one is the floodplain facies. And both of them are giving the distinct signatures on the satellite data. While the channel facies, which are represented as a custard apple texture, they are associated with the uranium mineralization. The other one are not. So that helps us in locating few of the satellite deposit in addition to the Domeshad deposit, which is one of the richest deposit in the country. This is the Wakin area. Similarly, in the Assam, we have the certain very important resources for the rare earth, where we have mapped. And we can see here the Samchampi alkaline carbonatite complex and the Baopeng alkaline complex, which was basically picked up on the satellite data. Another type, I mentioned the calcrete type of deposit, the surfacial type of deposit. This is part of the Rajasthan where we have got. And this basically is found in the earlier, the very recent sediment. And for that, basically we require the paleo channels. And for that, we have used a lot of the microwave data and also the multispectral data. Both of them has helped us in locating the number of paleo channels and whichever associated with the uranium mineralization in parts of the Barmer and the Jalore and Pali districts of the Rajasthan. But I certainly here want to mention that it is not only the satellite data, it is basically the integrated studies with the help of the other data products which come from the geophysical inputs like the magnetic, EM and the radiometric, which helps us in localizing the areas which are important for the exploration point of view. So this is the map which is prepared from the satellite data. Then we have the certain data which we have acquired from the geophysical one, like the magnetic, radiometric, and the EM data. And then we do the integration of all these data sets on the GIS platform and prepare the maps and finalize the data. This is part of the Kadapa Basin here. We can do the lot of good geological mapping with the help of the radiometric data, which is again helped by the satellite data and the other data sets. Similarly, we have another mandate that we have a lot of reserves of thorium along the beach sand, and the beach sands all along the country, they are monitored by or the explored by AMD for the thorium and the other rare earth. Rare earth comes as a byproduct. So there also a lot of satellite data is being used for the geomorphological mapping and also picking up the zones which are rich in the thorium. So this is the example of one of the part of the Krishna Delta, where we have done a lot of geomorphological mapping and picked up the areas for the thorium deposits, which are also rich in the other minerals like the garnet, ilmenite, and the other one. Apart from these studies, which are directly related to the atomic minerals exploration, we also use a lot of satellite data for selecting the nuclear power site and also the site for the repository, that is the for dissemination of the waste what we come across in the process of the nuclear power generation. Thank you.